Now your chapter number 7 triangle is over and we are now discuss to the next chapter, chapter number 8. The chapter number 8 is quadrilaterals. And one more thing, that chapter number 7 triangles has the optional exercise, and this optional exercise I will explain when the school will run as usual. Clear? So your revision will go on, and then the exercise optional I will complete it of every exercise, because through the video it is very tough to explain because the question is a little bit hot, high order thinking skill. Now chapter number 8 quadrilateral, one theorem is there: a diagonal of parallelogram divide it into two congruent triangles. Theek, that is the sign of triangle. A diagonal of parallelogram divide it into two congruent triangles. So how we will prove this? So first we will draw the parallelogram ABCD. So given ABCD is a parallelogram, because we are talking about the parallelogram, this is the sign of parallelogram. Here I am written completely, it is by the sign. We want to prove that angle ABC, this is the triangle, is congruent to triangle CDA. This triangle means these two triangles are congruent. Construction is needed to join diagonal AC. AC is the diagonal, one of the diagonal, we just join it. So this parallelogram divide into two triangles, and now we want to prove that these two triangles are congruent. Proof, how we will prove this? In triangle ABC and CDA, whatever it is required, we will write here these two triangles. AB equal to CD. Okay, and BC equal to DA. Why these two are equal? I think you know very well, these are the opposite side of parallelogram. So these two sides are equal. And one more thing, AC is belong to the this triangle, and AC also belong to the upper side triangle. Means this is the common side. So we will write here AC equal to AC, this is the common side. By the side, means triple S, these two triangles are congruent. These two triangles, triangle ABC and congruent to the triangle CDA by side angle side. Oh, sorry, side. And now just check angle A equal to angle C. Angle A equal to angle C. Do you know why these two angles are equal by the CPCT? It is making Z, alternate angle. Clear? Pause the video and note down.